Only survived 100 episodes, which is, I think, a good achievement.
Yes, it is. In the book, she dies like halfway through the first season. She would have died, so, or have a second season, rather. So I'm very honored to be here.
It's good. Well, now, we have new episodes coming soon.
Yes.
What's Mona going to be up to? And also, I'm curious, are the girls getting out of high school soon? Because they are getting older, so I'm curious about that, too. We're going to talk about the new episodes.
I think time moves very slowly in Rosewood, and, every episode is kind of like the next day, so we're gonna pick up where we left off. And as far as Mona goes, she is not happy that Allison is back, and she might be planning something to change that.
Okay, is she feeling kind of like the outsider again? Because she was kind of getting her way in, then she gets pushed out.
She told Allison, as we saw in the last episode, she told Allison to leave town and never come back. She came to town, back to town, and she's not happy.
Every time I dress up.
Okay, so can Allison and Mona survive together in town? Like, if they're both there,
that's the question.
Is Mona getting any man time with anybody?
There may be a surprising return of romance.
Okay.
Yeah, which I like. It shows a little bit of Mona's, softer side.
Okay.
She does have her folks. Surprise.
That's right.
She does.
She does. Now tell me about the Tarantino show a little bit. If people want to be in LA and see the show,
yes,
it's amazing.
Absolutely. We're going to be running through July. Probably going to extend more because thankfully it's doing well and people keep coming back, which is what we want. But it's so much fun. It's a musical mashup of movies, scenes from movies, Tarantino, and music from the soundtracks. And it's my passion. Music is my first love, and there's nothing like being on a live stage performing. So come see me if you love live entertainment in Los Angeles.
And we can see you and Payson together on stage.
Yes,
which
exactly.
Is amazing.
You both blow your socks off. He's amazing.
You both blow our socks off.
Hi, Cece. Drake, what a cool name, right?
It's a cool name.
Not the best name.
And I love that we definitely got a little bit more insight into her.
Oh, she is like, she's a broken spirit, right?
I know, and I love the show because you never fully know if somebody's fully bad or just has reasons for doing what they're doing. Where would you say Cece falls in that? Is she a villain, or is she just maybe...
Well, I mean, of course, I play her, so I think she's not a villain.
Okay, yes.
Because you're not supposed to judge her, I guess. But I think that she, like any good character, has a lot that she wants and a lot that she needs to get out of people.
Okay.
So I think she's somebody who is very much always kind of thinking 4 steps ahead to make sure that it leads to the ultimate result.
Okay.
Even when you see her kind of broken, that might be an honest moment, but it's still calculated, I think.
Okay. Are we seeing her a lot in these next new episodes?
You'll see her and hear about her and stuff.
Can you talk about who you're interacting with? I would guess Aria, but maybe not. Who are you interacting with?
I like working with everybody. I get to work with everybody.
Okay, that's good.
I can
take that.
Yes.
Okay. What do you have going on outside the show? Because I know you have some other stuff.
Yeah, I'm on the show Blue Bloods on CBS. So I shoot that in New York 9 months of the year, and then shoot this one whenever they let me out.
Yeah.
You know? So I play a cop on that show. It's Tom Selleck and Donnie Wahlberg. And
yeah,
it's really fun.
That's a whole different world.
Oh, it is totally different. It's so funny. My first day on, I shot an episode of Blue Bloods and an episode of Real Liars, like, almost right away. And so I'd been working on Real Liars, and it was like, everyone was in the making chair. I was like, getting, like, juices made, and we're having smoothies, and we're talking about, like, what makes our hair grow, and, like, all, like, typical, like, Real Liars making trailer stuff.
Right.
And then my first day on Blue Bloods, I walk in, and I kid you not, I walk in, and the whole makeup trailer is like, this is crazy. I ordered a pizza. I'm calling pizza. Hey, Vanessa, you want anything? What toppings do you want on your pizza?
Oh,
I was like, oh,
it's
different here.
It's like
this is a very
world,
different thing. It is, right?
Perfect.
It's super fun.